heard of Mozart.
Yeah.
Well, I think he probably wrote this when he was about 5 years old. For me, it's a simple piece of music, which there's something about Mozart that's fresh as a daisy. It's totally reliable, just like Gordon. It does everything right. It begins correctly and it ends correctly, provided the pianist plays it right. This is Andante. It's a very simple piece, and I am convinced he wrote it as a young person. I just have to touch this instrument. Okay. Just about dreaming. please don't get up. It's by Offenbach, and it's a barcarolle. So I suppose one could say it's an Offenbach roll. Probably don't know. long time ago, the BBC did a series of, well, I suppose you could call it a soap opera, it was in a way, and it was about a women's prison. And it was very well done. It was not, it didn't consist of bad language and awful behaviour. It really was about the sadness of the women in the prison. They were without their husbands and their children. And this piece was the signature tune of that series. It's called On the Inside. He used to give me roses. I wish he could again. But that was on the outside, and things were different then. About 13, I think, when I watched that, my mother let me stay up and watch about these women in prison, probably hoping that I'd learn a lesson or two. But I remember being very sad for them because he used to give her roses then. Mm. Anyway, am I allowed to keep playing? Yes.
Yeah.
this is a piece you won't know. This book is called Torch Songs. Do you know what torch songs are?
Yes.
No.
Have you ever held the torch for some bloke who did, you ladies? You say you held the torch and nothing happened? It had nothing to do with being in the dark. It was about falling in love with someone who couldn't care less about you. It never happened to me, of course. Torch songs, basically, I'm into sad music. Not sad music, I mean lovely melodies that tell a story.
She's digging her hole.
I don't hold the torch for anybody because I've got a bloke. So this one tells a story. love is funny, or it's sad, or it's quiet, not in my case, or it's mad. It's a good thing, or it's bad, but it's beautiful. And when you hear the word beautiful, when you hear piano play, it plays beautiful. So that is repeated throughout the song. I think it's lovely. It's written by Jimmy Van Heusen. Does anybody know that name? Okay. Anyway, but beautiful it is called.
Thank you.
another torch song, September song. Penultimate piece, right?
Yep. Windmills, right?
Yes, this is Windmills of Your Mind. Michel Legrand. When you listen to this, you can hear, watch the windmill going round. That's lovely. We've had an awful 12 months, haven't we? An awful 2 years, really.
2 years.
But it's amazing, isn't it? Someone said to me the other day when everything was going belly up, never mind, summer always follows winter. Well, that was quite nice of her to say that, but unfortunately the summer's been lousy as well, as well as everything else. Never mind. But sometimes you look out of the window and you see a rainbow. And if God's in his heaven, he's a bloody good painter. That's all I can say. It is the most wondrous sight to see a perfect rainbow. And the other day at Knightsbridge Village, it was absolutely perfect from one end to the other, and the second rainbow formed beyond it. I mean, God is in his heaven, isn't he? Despite what we'd like to think.